try to give you a hint as to why I think these are important, but I think you'll understand what they might be. Easily, number one, easily repaired items under $10. House inspectors often come back with a bunch of these types of things. There are a bunch of costs that are really 10 bucks or less, or around 10 bucks, basically minor types of things. And then buyers get all excited about them and crazy about them because they're on the inspector's list and they think that I got to have this all repaired. But remember what you're doing here is at some point in time, you've got some type of an agreement on the table and you're going back and changing that agreement for $10 items. So save yourself the hassle and just omit these items from the list of requested repairs. Don't even put them on there because what they're only going to do is cause you problems. Now, if it's a safety item or if it has to do with a breakdown of a more expensive item, it's not what I'm talking about here. I'm talking about small things, you know, an upside down plug outlet or something like that. I mean, just simple stuff. Basically, what I'm saying is don't sweat the small stuff. Number two, replacement of smoke detectors and carbon monoxide detectors. So sometimes what you get is an adamant buyer about this, right? I have to have the smoke detectors and I have to have the carbon monoxide detectors replaced and repaired, blah, 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 blah. And they get, it seems like it, because it's a safety issue or a safety concern, and it gets deeply rooted inside them. But I just want you to think of it this way. Let's just say that it's not a code in your area to do this. In other words, they're not saying you have to do this. In that case, wouldn't it be better if you get to decide where you want to put the smoke detectors and the carbon monoxide detectors? Because typically, when it's put up, they're drilling holes in the wall or the ceiling or something of that nature, and it's going to have to stay there. Well, maybe it's someplace you didn't want it. So if it's possible, why not just ask for them to be placed in the room, not adhered to a wall or a ceiling, just placed in the room, pass inspection, and then you put them where you want to put them. So just common sense. Again, repair issues that are code or safety, we're not talking about that, but we're talking about you making your own decision. Number three, cosmetic issues in a resale home, not necessarily in a new home, but cosmetic issues in a resale home. So if you've got some unevenness to the paint or the baseboards, maybe a slightly different color, you can see brush marks or things of that nature. It's normally something that you would talk about or that you would factor into your offer on the home. This is not something that you want to make an issue out of during the negotiations or during the counter, you know, the counter offer stages. It's going to turn into, well, you know what? I just don't want to do it. And how do you know there's not a backup offer or somebody just waiting to put an offer in on that house? Again, don't sweat the small stuff. Look at it way before you put in your offer and factor in the fact that you're going to have to factor in the fact. I like that. Factor in the fact that you're going to have to repaint the house. Number four, repairs related to minor plumbing and electrical issues. So often a home inspector will report everything that has to do with plumbing and electrical just because it saves their butt, right? So that's a cover your you-know-what type of a situation. But if it's something, remember I talked a little bit earlier about just an upside down panel or a light switch that's cracked or something of that nature. If there's some corrosion, on a fixture, unless these problems are cited as a safety concern or a code violation, it's just a simple repair that you can do yourself. Don't get it all crazy. Have a handyman do it later. But again, don't mess up your negotiations over simple electrical and plumbing, right? Removing a fixture that's discolored, you can do that later. In fact, you're probably going to want to do it. Number five, repair of hairline, emphasize hairline cracks in basement or driveway or concrete areas, wherever they might be. So concrete expands and contracts naturally, and over time, it cracks. And that's just the way it is. As long as the cracks are minor, don't list them in the request for repairs. However, If the brakes are over a quarter inch, so if they're thick, it's an excellent idea to have a structural engineer take a look at that. That's important. Structural cracks are a whole new ball game. That's not what I'm talking about. I'm talking about minor cracks, things that you can fill later. So figure out where your comfort zone is and determine minor and major. And if it's minor, leave it alone. If it's major, then get an engineer to tell you if it affected the foundation or it's affecting the entire structure itself. Number six, outdoor landscaping or porch and fence repairs. These items were visible when you first saw the house. So these are, again, not part of, you have to fix these, Mr. Seller, before I'll buy your house. No, this is part of negotiating the price in the beginning. So once you've passed that and you've seen all these obvious things where maybe you know you have to do some plant replacement, or maybe you know you have to upgrade the porch or paint it or put a new flooring, something like that. Now, there is an exception. If you're buying FHA, FHA has different guidelines than conventional loans, so you have to kind of pay attention to that. If it's FHA and it's in there, then you have to do it. Or if it's USDA, which, by the way, we'll talk about on another show. USDA loans are awesome. You should check them out. If it's something like that, then, you know, I get it. But if it's not mandated, then keep it out of this particular part of the process. Number seven, replacement of failed seals and windows. Okay. Unless the window is under warranty, most sellers are not going to mess with this. They're going to refuse to fix it. And window seals basically fail over time anyway. So it's something that would be considered normal wear and tear. It's expected when you're in this. So factor that in again. So most of the things that we're talking about today is a pick your battle situation. And for all the items on the list, some of them should have been taken care of prior to you putting in your bid on the house. And then some of them are after. It's really important that you understand which are which, because a seller is more likely to agree to $300 or $400 credit for the buyer than replacing 30 $10 items that they have to do, you know, over time, and they got to do them themselves, or they got to get somebody in. Separate these things out. Bottom line, don't mess with your closing over small things. Get your house, get her done, and don't sweat the small stuff. Okay. Second subject, we're going to boom, put it up. Are you ready to buy your house? Are you really ready to buy your house? So I'm going to ask you some questions.